How many games of chess are there? So there is a popular fact that the number of games of chess is greater than the number of atoms there are in the observable universe. This is the fact. Is it true? Well, the number of games of chess is known as Shannon's number. So let's find out what is Shannon's number and how it was worked out. Claude Shannon. He, in the 1950s, he wrote a paper, How to Program a Computer to Play Chess. It was about how to program a computer to play chess. And in that paper, he came up with an estimate for how many games of chess there are. So it is only an estimate. So he estimated that the number of games of chess would be 10 to the power, round about 10 to the power 120, which is, well, just massive. It's billions and trillions of Googles. It's so massive. That's a huge number. If we compare that with atoms in the observable universe, there's about 10 to the 80 atoms in the observable universe. So there are more games of chess. You could assign billions of games of chess for each atom in the universe. How did he come up with this massive figure? So what he decided was, well, he looked at some games of chess and he said, well, on average, at any position, there are about 30 legal moves that you can make. So the first player would have 30 legal moves he could make. And if you do two moves, that's the first player, then the second player, then that would be for each move by the first player, the second player would have 30. So if it was only two moves, it'd be 30 by 30. So that'd be 900 already, just with two moves. Some terminology here. When I'm saying moves, I actually mean what is called a ply. That means the one player goes first, then the second player goes next, then the next player. So in chess terminology, a move is the white player, then the black player. So another move would be a white player again, the black player again. But we're just going to say moves to be each player takes a move. It's actually called a ply. In chess terminology. So if the first player has 30 legal moves he can make, then for each move, the second player has another 30 legal moves he can make. So with just two moves, there are 900 moves you can make altogether. If it was three moves, it would be 30 by 30 by 30. If it was four moves, it'd be 30 by 30 by 30 by 30. Shannon said, well, a game is about 40 moves. That was in chess terminology. So he means 80 plays. So this is all Shannon did. He said, a game is about 30 legal moves, 80 plays, and that is around about 10 to the 120.
Well, that is the most wishy-washy.
Yeah. It was only in passing. It was only an estimate. It was only a paragraph of the paper. And he did this rough estimate, this rough number, to show that if you had a computer and it was trying to work out then the future of the game and trying to work out all the legal moves and where this game was going to go so that he could make decisions of how to play next, then the computer would never make a move. If it was calculating one game per microsecond, it would be until the end of the universe. It would never play. This was the point Shannon was trying to make with his rough estimates. So we're going to have a look at the sequence of games there are when each player takes their turn. So the first move is by white. So let's take the first move, and white has 20 legal moves. So we've got one here for each pawn. We've got, so that's eight. We've got the double move there by each pawn, so we've got 16. We've got two moves there for each knight. Two moves on this side here and here. And that's 20. So 20 moves for the first player. Now black takes the next turn. And for the next turn, well, he can respond with the same 20 moves. So for each move player one takes, black can take 20 moves. So you multiply, it's 20 by 20. There are now 400 games that could have happened already. With just two moves, there are already 400 games that could have happened. Let's see what happens next. then suddenly it becomes much more complicated. When white plays next, it becomes 8,902 moves. Suddenly, 8,000, nearly 9,000 games that you can play with just three plays.
This sounds a lot more precise than what Shannon was doing. This is real numbers.
Yeah, these are real numbers. With these small numbers, we can work this out. So far, so good. It's going to get harder with larger numbers. So let's write out a few more. The next move is black, and he'll have 197,742. So after black moves again, we now have 197,742 possible games that could have been played. All the possible games we could have done in those four moves is already 200,000.
This is crazy.
It's huge numbers already, huge numbers.
Although, you are able to know exactly what the number is, so it just seems like if you spend enough time on this, you'll be
able to... So, okay, we can keep going, can't we? So we can keep going, and these numbers are going to get bigger and bigger. Now, in theory, the total number, the largest number, the longest chess game, can be something around 11,800 of these plies. 11,800. And that's invoking, though, you have to invoke the 50 move rule, because you could just go on forever. If you just ended up with two kings just going backwards and forths, a game could last forever. So there is a rule that stops a game lasting forever that says, well, if you've played 50 moves with nothing being captured and you're just messing about,
or,
then it's...
Or a pawn being moved, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a pawn hasn't moved, something hasn't been captured, or you repeat the board three times. If that happens, then you call it a draw. So there's a cut-off point. Now, some people have worked out what the longest possible chess game is. It's something around 11,800. There's some disagreement, not much disagreement, though, within 100 or so of that. So if you see how fast this sequence is growing, can you imagine how many games there are altogether? Especially when you're going all the way up to nearly 12,000 moves. Some of those games will be nonsense games, where you can win, you've only got one move left and you can win in one move, but you don't. You start moving other pieces and you start doing other things. It becomes a massively complex tree of possibilities. And that's why this number is just going off to huge numbers. Godfrey Hardy, a famous 20th century mathematician, he tried to estimate the number of chess games there were. His estimate was 10 to the power 10 to the power 50. To the power of 50. Let me say that again. It was 10 to the power 10 to the power 50. This is minuscule when you compare it with what Hardy's estimate was. What Shannon was doing was saying, this is a 40-move game, where the average number of moves is 30. So he was saying that if there were 80 plays, that's what he's saying. He's saying this is about 10 to the power 120. That's what Shannon is saying. So he's not even considering all these other games. So it was Godfrey Hardy, the famous 20th century mathematician, worked at Cambridge, discovered Ramanujan. He tried to estimate how many games of chess there were. It was actually when he was writing about Ramanujan, because Ramanujan had sent him a paper which had a large number in it. He said, just to understand how big this number is, if you compare it to the number of games of chess, I reckon that's 10 to the power 10 to the power 50. Was Hardy close? I don't know. He didn't give any working out for this. This was in passing. I did say a lot of these would be nonsense games. Let's try some sensible estimates. If it was, let's say if each player had an average of three sensible moves instead of 30 legal moves, same sort of idea. If we did that, so instead of 30 to the power 80, it would be, say, 3 to the power 80. Does that seem more reasonable? Yeah, so if that's 3 to the power 80, I can tell you that's round about 10 to the 40. So now not as large as the number of atoms in the observable universe, still Still very large, though. 10 to the 40. If, for example, everyone in the world paired off and they had to play a game of chess every day, and it had to be a different game every day, and they did that to play all possible games, this 10 to the 40 sensible games, it would still take you trillions and trillions of years to play them all. Or if you think about it another way, we consider all games of chess that have ever been played in history, then that is only a tiny fraction of all the possible games of chess that are to play.
I can't think of a better supporter for a video about chess than a company called Squarespace. Now, if you want a presence on the web, whether it's a blog, a business, or just a cool way to tell the world about what you're doing, then Squarespace is a super resource. I host my own blog on Squarespace, and it's so quick and hassle-free. In a matter of minutes, I can have anything up on the web looking great, and that's looking great on both computers and mobile devices, which is often the hard bit. Now, whether you're a bit of a novice or you are a coding grandmaster, Squarespace will give you as little or as much control as you like. So whatever your end game, you really should check them out. You see what I did there? Check them out, end game. That's pretty good, that. Anyway, they've got a great range of templates to get started. Then you can tweak them, play around until your heart's content. And I'm not just saying this because they've sponsored today's episode, which they have, and thank you for that, but I am a happy customer. Now, you can have a 14-day free trial. Give it a go before you commit. No credit card required. And then if you do like them, you can get 10% off your first purchase. Go to squarespace.com/numberphile. And thanks to Squarespace for supporting this episode. As they like to say, build it beautiful.
Do you play chess?
I do play chess. I know chess. I know I'm no expert on chess. I'm no grandmaster. I play chess for fun, perhaps. I used to play chess with my dad.